Good day, New Creation family. We're reviewing the book of the month, which is titled The Tech Wise Family by Andy Crouch. And the Fire Tukasi family will be reviewing the part two of it, which is titled The Daily Life. And the part two has been divided into subtitle into about five of them or six of them, which we, you know, quickly talk about in few minutes now. So the number one part of it is sleeping and waking with our devices, learning and walking, boredom, the deep end of the carpool, and the last bit of it, naked and unashamed. So we're quickly going to talk about those subtitles in few minutes. And if you have not started reading the book, I encourage you to do so, because the book is very, very informative and is very, very practical as well. So quickly, sleeping and waking with our devices. The author is actually encouraging us that we should apply some discipline when we are using our devices. There's nothing wrong using all these technological-based devices, iPhone, iPad, laptop, TV set, and the rest. But what he's saying is that we need to apply discipline. E.g., he said that our device should go to bed before we do. And then in the interval between putting device to bed and laying our bed, we can use that moment, spend few minutes just talking to God, praying, reading some informative books. And when you do that, that will give you a kind of rest of mind before you actually go to bed, and then you can have a very good sleep. And when you wake up as well, we have this habit of quickly wake up and checking our phone and all that. But he's encouraging us that before we do that, we should wake up before our devices could even wake up at all. Then he's saying that we should allow God to be enough for the day. And you can do something different. Aside checking your phone early and all that, you can as well just take a walk, you can as well pray, you can as well just do a mini exercise and the rest. So that's what it's encouraging us to do. Then it quickly goes to the number two of it, which is learning and walking. He said we should aim for no screen before double digits at school and at home. In other words, he's just trying to tell us that physically engaged activities helps to develop our brains. And it will help us to avoid complacency as well. In other words, he used an example that if you are trying to play a guitar or learn how to play a guitar, it's more practical because it engages you physically. It engages your brain. It engages every activities in your body and everything. Rather than, for example, you download an app to play a guitar on your phone or on your iPad, that's more easy. It doesn't engage your brain. It doesn't engage you, you know, physically or any otherwise. So that is what he's trying to advise us to do. Then he look at boredom. He said boredom, we tend to think that, you know, all these devices take away boredom from us, but in other words, it doesn't. So he's encouraging us that, okay, we should try as much as possible to create an atmosphere whereby we will not be bored. Taking a walk in the garden, you know, stay with your family, having a laugh, go for a dinner, do something different apart from attached to your devices all day. Because sometimes all this news from social media, all this negativity from social media can even create boredom for us. So that's what he's saying in essence. So if you can as much as possible to avoid all those things, it will really help us. Then the fourth part of it, which is the deep end of the carpool. That is a very, very important aspect. I want you to read that aspect very well, because what he's saying in that aspect is that many conversations that are so fruitful and motivating are happening in the car. You see, car time is the conversation time. That is the time that the couples have time for themselves to be able to communicate and talk the truth between themselves. You see, it's a time whereby the parents have to talk with their children, or the children have a very good conversation with their parents. Talk about their school, talk about their future, talk about something that is meaningful. So he said we should separate that moment. We should not allow phone or any other devices to take that moment from us. Because what happened is that most people, once they get into the car, everybody is on the phone. There is no communication. There is no any conversation that is meaningful, that can transform your life, that can change your relationship, that can change your future for better. Whereas everybody is just busy on the phone. He said we should not allow our devices to take that moment away from us. And then the last bit of it, which is naked and unashamed. So what he's saying is, in essence, is that we should be open to ourselves, both couples open to each other, then the parents should be able to have access to their children devices, so vice versa. In doing that, we will not be ashamed of ourselves, we will not be having any privacy. So we can even encourage that the couple should be able to have, you know, access to the password of their partner's devices, which is very, very good as well. In other words, that is telling us that we should not be ashamed of ourselves. We should just be open to ourselves. And I pray that as we do this, God will help us. If you have not read that book, just go and read it. And I pray as you do so, God will bless your family. God will bless your life. Your life will change for better. Everything that we are all looking for in 2021, God will make it happen for us as a whole, as a family, as individual. God bless you. Bye.